Good afternoon, everyone. In the state of Odisha, since the beginning, we have worked very hard in a very planned manner and put in place a very robust system to handle this pandemic. We have complied with the instructions issued by Ministry of Home Affairs, Government of India, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. We have done our homework, we have consulted experts. So, all in all, we have been able to manage our public health comparatively better than most states, and we have got compliments from many. The Honorable Chief Minister has discussed with his counterparts in Karnataka state, Tamil Nadu, Gujarat and Maharashtra, from where we were expecting a lot of Odias who are stranded. So naturally, since the Government of India has permitted their entry, their exit from those states and to cross their borders, we are expecting them. We have planned, we issued detailed SOPs, and this morning we have received a special train with more than 1,000 passengers from Kerala. So this the passengers alighted at Jagannathpur in Ganjam district and Khordha Road in Khordha district. They were meant for 20 districts. Elaborate arrangements were made, and they were taken by buses to their respective panchayats, where they will be put in into the quarantine, mandatory quarantine for up to 14 days minimum, and if necessary, even more. The people who tirelessly worked through the night to receive them in a safe manner, did their health screening, provided them food, water, baby food, then sanitized the entire place, and very, very carefully put them in their respective buses. So this is something which I'd like to thank everyone who have contributed so much to this arrangement. We are now receiving a lot of people by road, and even though we have mandated that the persons who come from outside will have to come with valid passes issued by competent authorities from those states, we find there are some infractions. Some people are appearing without passes, or they are coming with overcrowded buses, or when they are being sent through a route chart, which is an approved sticker pasted on their windscreen, they are sometimes, we find they are violating the route. So we have now told all concerned at the border checkpoint, en route and in the district, very strict action would be taken against these violations. Overcrowding, not going on the approved route, and then we have also found some instances of minority of people who are in quarantine, who are jumping quarantine or creating a lot of indiscipline act in the quarantine center. Only for a small people will not let the public health of the large number of people be perilled. We are issuing instructions to all concerned, and the primary functionary is Panchayat, the Sarpanch, who has been already empowered to act against these people, to take strict legal action. In some cases, we will shift them from their home panchayat to distant panchayats in the other districts and increase their quarantine period, not give them the incentive money promised because they have violated the quarantine condition. We'll also arrest them and put them in jail if it's a serious infraction. Then, the Sarpanches have done extremely well till now. They have made very good arrangements. I will only make 2-3 requests to them. Sarpanches should be very, very vigilant about quarantine conditions. It's a legal condition. So it's not a voluntary quarantine. It is a legal quarantine. They have to undergo quarantine. The moment they violate quarantine, strict legal action be taken. Second, the health protocol issued for the quarantine center should be completely administered. So the Sarpanches will have to look into that. Third thing, I want the community support to these instructions, so that not only legal action would be taken, the community also should oversee the quarantine center. Thank you.